Hey, how you doing? Gamo here. So, I have a lot to talk about in this vlog, so I'll try and make it as quick as I possibly can. Just kidding. So, one of the biggest questions that has come up recently, kind of recently-ish, is where are my Starbound videos? And this is a question that I've answered in a few different locations, including a couple of Starbound videos, and I think I mentioned it during one of my vlogs. But I wanted to make something a little bit more official. It is on hold right now. What's going on? Well, what was going on was that the entire team for Chucklefish was in transition to the UK. Most of them have actually been moved by this point, so there was a lot of things that were on hold. A lot of mods weren't getting updated because there was a lot of things that were on hold, but there were still small updates going on, so mods were getting broken, which actually broke my survivalist mod, so that's also been on hold because of that. The main and biggest reason that there haven't been as many Starbound videos is because Starbound is on the verge of a humongous rework. Just complete overhaul. As you guys know right now, the current system is basically Alpha, Beta, Gamma, Delta, and X Sector. That is going to be getting completely removed. What they're going to be putting in its place is one universe where basically you have a set of planets that you can go to based on biome. So you can go to like a grassland biome, and the stuff that you find on that planet will allow you to craft something like a survival system that allows you to then go to a moon planet, which you wouldn't have been able to go to without the survival system. And then on those moon planets and other systems that, or other planets that don't have atmosphere, you'll then be able to make something that allows you to progress onto the next planet, like, I don't know, a lava planet where you have to be able to swim through lava to do something. So that's how they're going to be reworking the progress for the game, and that's going to break... I'd be amazed if it didn't break pretty much everything. I mean, there's going to be some things that don't get broken, like paint tools and the wiring tools and whatnot, but a lot of stuff is going to get broken. What they're also going to do is they're going to introduce two other universes that are completely independent from each other and from, obviously, the main story, and that is PvP and Creative. So I will be floating around Creative a lot. I'll have a Let's Play going on the main universe, of course, as well. PvP, we'll see how they do with it. I'm not terribly impressed with the PvP of any 2D game. And that's just being completely honest. Like, every time I played games like Awesome Knots, I wasn't impressed. It's a 2D game. Yeah, you can add all kinds of cool stuff into it, but eh. I don't know. 2D PvP has just never really pulled me in that much, but we'll see where they go with it. Once things are mellowed out a lot more, and once the main progression comes out, and once they start doing more updates like that, I will be definitely just spitting constant videos out. The other thing that I wanted to let you guys know about relating to Starbound is the Starbound project that you guys know that I'm working on. The guy that is actually working on this with me is going to be moving into the same house as me. So that's going to allow us to get a lot of progress done. You'd be amazed how much that does for you. I mean, that's the whole reason this, the Chucklefish team is moving into one place. It allows them to make a lot of progress. The next concern that has come up is, why are there horror games? Now, I said a long time ago, when I first started this channel, that I'm not going to become a horror Let's Player, and I am still sticking to that. However, I will admit that during the time when Outlast and Daylight came out, I did a little too much horror, and I apologize for that, and that's not going to happen again. Horror games will make an appearance every now and then, but it's definitely not going to be anything like the bigger YouTubers that play horror, you know, like once a week or, you know, several times a week. It's not going to be a common thing. I'm also going to be getting more into a lot of more goofy games. Like, I've enjoyed Cube. That's probably been my most favorite game that I've been playing recently. As a matter of fact, the developers of the game have been watching the Cube videos, which, a huge shout out to Liquid Flower Games. Liquid Flower Games, thank you so much for coming by and watching my videos. I'm a tiny YouTuber, and the fact that you are interacting with channels like me, and I know you've spoken with others as well, the fact that you're interacting with any of us is, quite honestly, not only flattering, but a huge notion that you actually care about the game and you care to see the reviews of not just the big guys, but the little guys like me and, you know, and their fans. So I think I speak for my fans when I say thank you. Thank you for coming by, and we appreciate it. It's amazing. Just some other random stuff that I wanted to talk about. I have gotten my outro song picked. I know exactly what song I'm going to use for my outro. I mentioned it on Twitter a few weeks ago. If you guys aren't following me on Twitter, definitely check out my Twitter. I actually post a lot of little things that just don't deserve a full video. I post a lot of little things on there. So if you guys haven't followed me on Twitter already, go follow it. I have been using it I know a long time ago I said I hated Twitter, but I've warmed up to it. Back to the outro. I found a song, it's royalty free, it's gonna be getting used. I just need to work on an outro art. I need to see if I can do kind of like an animation for it, you know, just for like my picture. I'm also working on a new avatar and I think I might use that for the end. I don't know, I've got a lot of things that I'm still working on. The outro for Starbound. There have been a few things that have come to my attention that might stop me from using that song anymore. And I know a lot of you enjoyed that song, and I love the song, obviously. I wouldn't have picked it. So that might be getting changed. We'll see. I don't know. I'm still going to be using the outro art because that art was amazing. Thank you again. But the song might be getting changed. We'll see, though. And the last thing I want to put out there is that since everyone's now in the office for Chucklefish for the Starbound, they've actually been posting updates daily, sometimes twice or more daily, and that's freaking awesome. So I actually have some pretty big updates for you. Now, this first update's going to be a little bit older, but because they posted some more information about the monsters and how they're going to work, I figured it would be good to bring this up. One of the biggest things that they're doing is they're reworking the entire combat system. One of the things that they're removing to change the combat is knockback. Knockback's not going to be as prevalent as it used to be. There will be things that stun, and there will still be things that do knockback, but getting knockback every time you get hit is probably going to get removed entirely. Now, they've been talking about it, and there's a few things that they're still thinking about, but for the most part, it is going to get removed. What they're doing also is that they're making it so that monsters no longer want to stand inside you. What they're going to do is if they're a melee attacker, they're going to walk up and then attack you. They'll do an animation and then attack you. They also might make it so that monsters no longer hurt you when they stand inside you, which makes sense. I mean, they might make it where if you're standing inside them, they'll do like a quick swipe attack to get you off of them, but actually touching them will likely no longer matter. They're also adding in blocking and parrying. Well, blocking's been in there, but they're reworking how it works. When you block, it will basically make it so that it will stun the monster, and it'll do some damage to your shield. It'll basically have like a health bar that recharges, kind of like in Halo, you know, when you get hit, your shield recharges. It's gonna be kind of the same thing. So if you put your shield down and make it so it doesn't get hit, it'll recharge. But if you keep letting it get hit, it'll eventually break your guard and you won't be able to block for a little while. And similarly, for two-handers, you'll be able to parry. But the way that parrying will work is instead of holding the block button, you will have to hit the parry button at exactly the right time to deflect the monster and do a counterattack. Now, they haven't given a huge amount of details on this next part, but they are in the progress of reworking the game progression, as I mentioned earlier. One of the big steps that they're taking towards that is adding in the ship upgrade system that they were talking about at the very beginning. That is one thing that they are working very hard on right now, and they were doing a whole bunch of screenshots showing how it worked. Basically, you have your ship that we see, and then behind the scenes, there's basically a grid that governs how each and every piece of the ship works. Rather than it be like a block that you can manipulate like in the normal Starbound world, it's basically an entire structure that interacts with each other. They're also working on the AI for the ships, and what that's going to allow it to do is basically when you go up and talk to the AI, you'll get all of your normal options like the 3D printer, you'll be able to upgrade the ship, and basically any ship options will be done through the computer AI, which is pretty sweet, and they've been posting some pictures about how that's coming along as well. The reason I brought up the combat system, and that's what was the old update, the reason I brought that up is because it kind of ties into what they're doing with monster spawning. Monster spawning is going to be more dependent on biomes, basically where you find them on the actual planet itself. You know, if it's a cold planet, you might find creatures who look like yetis. If it's a magma planet, you might find these lizard-like creatures. It's going to depend more on where they spawn or where they're located, and also that will determine their density. So there could be a lot more of them spawning, you know, a bunch of little guys who don't do a lot of damage, but there's a swarm of them, so it could be a problem in itself. And then also the other part of it is, and this is a really old update, is that they were talking about the monster parts, like the arms, the head, the legs, and determining what abilities they use. That's also going to be tying into the monster spawning, since that's something that they're working so heavily on right now. And basically the last part of it is that they got a ton of bug fixes that they're working on. I really hope that this has a huge impact on the multiplayer of Starbound, because One of the things that you guys know I loved doing was playing Starbound with you guys. Well, every time we would play, no matter what server it was, it would crash every 10 to 15 minutes. And that's just a miserable experience for you guys. I don't want you guys to have to, like, form this huge group, and then it gets broken because the game server crashes, and then we form another group, and then it crashes again. That just sucks. So I really hope that they dedicate some time to the multiplayer aspect of it. I would love to see it be more stable than it is right now. Now I know a lot of the problems actually aren't related so much to multiplayer, but basically how the game handles information. And they are reworking the entire game as far as how information gets reworked. They're doing a lot of bug fixes, a lot of overflow bugs, which basically causes a lot of crashing. They're working on a lot of that. So I'm confident that what they're working on right now will fix a lot of the problems that we experienced during multiplayer. Alright, well, holy crap, that was a really long vlog. If you stuck all the way through to the end, thank you so much. I really do appreciate it. It helps me a lot watching the entire video, so thank you for doing so. I really hope you guys are having a great day. Thank you so much for watching the video. In the meantime, take care of yourself.